AI search is not the future, it is now. But AI doesn't just find your content, it actively decided whether to recommend your brand or ignore it completely. So we have to rethink the whole optimization process, like building three kinds of relationships with AI. First, make AI love your content so it uses them as source. And second, make AI trust your brand so it recommends you. And third, make AI not hate your site so it doesn't reject you. In this video, I partnered with Semrush to show you how to optimize all three relationships with six methods that you can copy right away. Let's go. To do real SEO optimization, data is a must. So that's why the methods I'm going to show you follow these key strategy. Data first, AI second. I know we all use AI, but without the data, you are simply guessing. For this video demo, I'll be using Semrush ONE, a new solution that combines two toolkits, the traditional SEO toolkit and the AI visibility toolkit. If you want to follow along, there is a link in the description where you can sign up to get an exclusive 14-day free trial. All right, the first relationship, make AI love your content. AI ignores you because you are irrelevant. So the first quick win is to optimize the traditional SEO ranking. Yes, traditional search. Study shows that there is a strong correlation between Google rankings and AI citations. Like in my case, I have a blog rendered for the keyword on organic search is also being cited on Google AMO. So for example, I am optimizing tightdream.com, an AI website builder. So first we can just quickly check its domain overview. And Semrush now also includes this AI visibility score and the breakdown of both the brand mentions and cite the pages across different AI search engines. Just scroll down, you can also see the snapshot of the top sources for both AI search and Google search. And meaning for this brand, there's still lots of AI optimization opportunities. Now, instead of just looking at your own random keywords, use the keyword gap analysis under the SEO toolkit. Insert a competitor, pick one that has a similar product offering, an audience for more relevant analysis. So it will tell you what is missing, where search engines already associate your competitors with a niche but not you. So here you will see a list of shared keywords, and there's so many keywords, but that doesn't mean we need to follow every one of them. So there are two ways to get a more targeted list. So first way is to filter by a topic keyword. And so perhaps in this case, that is website builder. So you will have a much more meaningful scope where you can do a deeper analysis. And the second way is to filter by position. So for example, filter only the page 2 to page 3 random keywords to get a list of high potential keywords. As for the search volume and keyword difficulty, they can be a good reference, but don't get too obsessed, but focus on those relevant to your target ICP and business. AI search is about context, not just volume, and then export this list of potential keywords. So how do we know exactly what are the areas to improve? And so we need to use Perplexity comments. If you prefer other agentic AI browser, that's fine. So just upload this list of keywords and ask it to review the search result page, browse through each of the top ranked keywords and our page to identify a list of optimization areas that we can follow in order to improve our own ranking. And this is one of the best ways of using AI for SEO because this is low risk and highly automated. So it will return all the key findings and it comes up with a content optimization checklist, breakdown by each keyword. Now you still need to validate the output, but this will give you a strong starting point about the directions and immediate improvement areas. A bonus tip is try to update any outdated statistic, add new perspective, and then refresh your published date. AI rewards content freshness, and all these small updates will signal your content is current and relevant. Now, what if your website is fairly new and doesn't even have existing content to optimize? The quick win here is not starting creating content yet, but to know which topics to prioritize first. AI is based on probability of words, and that means when your brand is being associated in a certain topic, keywords more often, you are literally training the AI that you own certain expertise in that area and willing to cite you more as a source. So the SEO toolkit has a feature called Keyword Strategy Builder. So it will base on your seed keyword and help you to map out all those potential and relevant topic cluster. Let's say the keyword is AI website builder. So after a few minutes, it analyzes almost 2,000 keywords and generates these topical overview. And don't underestimate these kind of planning because topic cluster can train AI to recognize you have an authority in these areas. So it breaks down by different topic cluster, and inside there is still a pillar page and a sub page. And for each page, it will also give you a list of target keywords that could help you to establish the authority for that cluster. So everything is very detailed, and it even highlights some of the high potential subtopics. Now let's export all of them just for demo purpose. Now we can prioritize these topic clusters to make sure they are really relevant to your brand and target audience. And I highly suggest using Gemini for this task because Gemini has a large contextual window size that can analyze large data sets. So upload the data set and your brand overview document and ask it to prioritize these clusters based on the brand fit. And immediately it will help you to do this prioritization by finding the relevant topic cluster with the priority on the brand angle that we should approach and also the top keywords we should target. So using this method, you can quickly build a high-level content strategy plan that is ready for execution. All right, now you're clear about the topics that you should prioritize for AI search and you start creating content. But what kind of content? AI doesn't just match keywords, it matches the intent and semantic understanding. And that's why to make AI love your content needs to address a very specific and contextual needs about people's questions. So for example, from the content strategy plan, we know that portfolio website is a strong target keyword for one of the topic cluster. Now there are at least two ways to get these related questions on Semrush. First, we can go to the keyword magic tool under the SEO toolkit. So enter the keyword. Now you can also enter your domain to make sure the data is more personalized for you. And then go to the question tab. Here is a list of real user questions that they ask related to this keyword. So most of them are informational search intent, like how to make a good portfolio website for marketing. Informational intent still matters in AI search, but only if it's relevant to your business. So review all these keywords and then export this list of questions. A bonus is you can also click the SERP overview icon to check the SERP analysis. So some questions you can see is ranked better as a video, while some as images. So you can use this to identify the best content format for that question. Another way to get question is to go to the prompt research under the AI visibility toolkit. So this is a new prompt database containing 100 million plus prompts. Just enter your topic or seek keyword. Semrush will suggest predefined topics based on your keyword. So just pick the most relevant. And then you will see the AI volume, prompts, top brands, and source domain for this topic. And you can even filter by platform like ChatGPT, Google AI Mode, AI Overview. So for these topic about portfolio website and examples, we can click on the full response for any of these prompts, and it will give you the response snapshot, the top brands being mentioned, the sources being used. And once you find prompts that you want to track, you can just click monitor to start the tracking process. Or you can go to the prompt tracking section, set up your project, and start tracking any of your custom prompts on your preferred AI search engines. As for the brand view, it shows who you are actually competing against for this topic and which are mentioned the most. You can also navigate to the source domain view. It shows where AI pulls information from, like this case, YouTube, LinkedIn, Reddit. So these might be all the potential channels this brand can focus on. So let's optimize for this prompt, how to make a digital portfolio. Now I can copy all the sources from the response, then go to NotebookLM and import all these URL as sources. Then we can ask it to analyze these sources and generate the custom instructions for an AI search optimization content. And then it will give you really detailed analysis and what are the core elements, like semantic keywords to be used for this content. And then we can use the built-in studio feature to generate the blog post using these exact custom instructions. And immediately you have this content draft that is backed by the analysis from all the top cited sources. And very important is don't just copy this output. AI reward information game. Always add your own experience and perspective. So with this content plan, you have built your own content. But which topic are AI search engines actually mentioning your competitors for? What sources they use? And this matters because AI doesn't randomly pick who to cite. So by reverse engineering what they're doing right, your content will have a much higher chance to get cited as well. So using the same example, this time go to the AI visibility overview. So this shows how often your brand is mentioned and cited across ChatGPT, AI Overview, AI Mode, and Gemini. So you can scroll down to see your top performing topics. So click on any topics to see which prompts mention you and which ones are missing. So like this topic about codeless website builders, so you can break it down to check the prompts details. You will immediately get the insights about the topic opportunities you should focus on. And then the site source give you the top domains where your brand is being mentioned and the source opportunities for domains that you're missing. Now you can check the top cited pages where your domain is being used as source. And you can always click on that to break down the prompt details. So that is the baseline. Now let's also compare against the competitors to find the real gap. So this will show you exactly which topic to prioritize and who's the content to reverse engineer. So go to competitor research, enter a prominent competitors. So immediately you see how your AI search visibility compares to other competitors in terms of the mentions, topics, and prompts, and cited sources. So you will see which topics they're getting mentions for that you are not. Or you can just go to the source view that shows how you compare with competitors across these sources. Now the quick win is to identify the weak topics where your brand is being mentioned, but not as frequent as they. So like this one, are there any good alternatives to Figma? So we can copy all the sources, repeat the same process in NotebookLM, but this time also upload your own web page. So now the key is to ask it to compare and identify any missing elements that can improve the AI citations, and then prepare all those new insights and then use the same method to generate the optimized content. And now we can even take a step further to ask it to generate a decision flowchart infographic on NotebookLM, which is powered by the Nano Banana model. So we'll make it more multimodal for AI citations. All right, the second relationship is making AI trust you. And essentially, it's all about your brand reputation and how others talk about you. The truth is, AI doesn't just check your website. It validates authority across platforms to make sure your brand is trustable before it even mentions your brand or cites you as a source. So the goal here is to build enough authority signals outside your own domains and reinforce it. So the first way is to find third-party publications. So this time, let's use another example, webflow.com, just for the sake of demo. So under the AI visibility, click brand performance. So unlike AI analysis, brand performance focuses on tracking how AI perceive your brand and share of voice. So enter the domain and target location. It would take some time for it to pull the results across all AI search engines. So now it shows you share of voice and sentiment against your competitors, leading key business driver, broken down by key AI search engines. So you can see where you're leading or falling behind. Now go to the narrative driver for deeper analysis about the share of voice. So you can just select any of the target AI search engines for insights. So in this case, you can see Webflow is over leading other competitors, especially on ChatGPT. So you will know which AI search engines to focus on. And the question section here is goal. So these are specific branded and non-branded questions showing how the brands get cited and their ranked position. So you can use this to understand what third-party sites cares about when you pitch them. Particularly, you can filter those questions where competitors rank but you don't. So to build the offsite signals, go to the top citations. This lists the most influential domains in your niche, like publications, major media, social channels, and you can even filter the mentioned brand or click any third-party domain to see the site pages you can target and what exactly the page is talking about. And you can browse through each of them to see if there is a potential for outreach. Now the second way is to leverage the social media platforms and communities. As multi-social channel presence and mentions, we increase the trust signals for your brand. So again, on the cited pages, filter all those well-known social domains like Reddit, YouTube, LinkedIn, Quora. So it will give you a list of threads that are driving the brand mentions, where you can participate and drive your brand narratives. Perhaps maybe YouTube, LinkedIn. What are the popular content topics that are driving the brand mentions or might be worth doing an influencer campaign? So pick those brand mention triggering topics that are relevant. So like this one for LinkedIn about the best practice of site migration, which will resonate with our target audience. Now to speed up the whole process, we can export the full list and then fill into Gemini together with the brand overview. So immediately it will visualize the sources that have have high potential and also have great brand fit where we can outreach. And my tips when outreaching is don't just ask to be included. All the real values, whether it's unique data, updated statistic, or expert quote on the topics they already cover. The third relationship, making AI not hate your site. So this is actually the most important. You can have great content, but if AI can't access your site, none of it matters. You are invisible. So it's critical to do an SEO audit for your website for AI search. So go to the site audit under the SEO or AI visibility token. I have already done an audit with this SEO project. If you haven't done yet, you can just click here to create a new SEO project. So after you have done the site audit, you will see an audit summary telling you the overall site healthiness. And especially there is a new panel for AI search healthiness, so which gives you an idea if your site is technically optimized for AI search. Now I know sometimes there might be many SEO technical issues, but in reality, not every issue needs to be fixed. It requires your own judgment. But for AI search in particular, there are three areas that I suggest you to look at. So the first one is the page crawlability. So Semrush will check if your robot.txt file block any AI search bots. In this case, it is blocking Gemini from crawling, which needs to be fixed. And you can click to show more other crawl healthiness for other AI bots as well, or click to check the list of blocked pages. The second area is to check the site structure. So go to the crawl pages. So here it will break down the site structure for you based on the crawled pages. By the way, this demo just show you the 100 crawled pages. And the goal here is to make sure this site structure does not have too much foldering, because not every AI search engines have their own search index. It's resource intensive. So some of them still rely on the traditional search index to find the content. And that's why a more flat structure can help the AI easily scan and index all your pages. And also make sure the crawl depth is no longer than 3, because higher crawl depth meaning the site structure is complex. So for this case, 1 to 2 crawl depth is great. And the third thing is to look at the markup report. So schema markup is structured machine readable data. So it helps search engines to understand your site content, especially identify the entities like places, organizations, products, FAQ, articles, and easy for AI search engines to extract, interpret, and collect the information. So for this domain, the schema markups is all missing, and we should add it back at least for those key markups. AI search optimization seems complex, but the core principles is simple. Provide helpful content. Help your target audience find the answers faster. Think from your audience perspective. How can your brand become their go-to source? Visibility is just the end results. The real input is being genuinely trustworthy. If you enjoyed this video, please give me a thumbs up and join our community for more resources. And before you go, also watch this video about the AI search roadmap. I will see you next time.